So hi guys, my name is Siddhant and welcome back to a new video. We all know that entrepreneurship or starting a startup is a team game, right? You cannot do everything all alone. And if you try to do everything all alone, then you are just a self-employed person. Not having the right people on your team, not hiring well in the initial days, not having a strong founding team, core team for your startup is one of the major reasons why startups fail. You can see here that not having the right team is the third most common reason for the failure of startup. About 23% of the startups fail because they don't have the right founding team, they don't have a strong initial team. So if you're a young entrepreneur, if you're just starting out, and if you're not sure about how to go about hiring new people in this competitive, cutthroat environment of business, then this video is for you. In this video, I'll cover three aspects, that is, for what positions you should hire initially, how to hire your initial team members, and third, what are the important points that you should remember while hiring, right? So do watch this video till the end. It is a very important video. It is going to be very interesting. And if you like the video, then do like the video, share, comment, subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to hit the bell icon to receive the latest notifications of my videos on time. So hi guys, so as I've told you that initial team, the founding team, the core team makes all the difference, right? And 23% of the startups fail just because they don't hire the right people and at the right time. And if you don't want to be one of those, then you should start focusing on hiring the right people, great people from now on. So as you can see on the screen, these are the top 5 reasons why startups fail. That is no market need, that is a major reason. And the second reason is ran out of cash. The third reason is not having the right team. The fourth is getting outcompeted. And the fifth is price and cost issues, right? But if you get your team right, then you can automatically solve two of those problems. The first is ran out of cash, and the second is getting outcompeted, because if you have a great team, you can attract great investors to invest in a business. So you will always have great amount of resources. And also, if you have a great team, then it will definitely work hard towards that goal, and it will definitely work hard to make the startup a success, and it will not get outcompeted by the competition, right? So if you get this one thing right, that is getting the initial team, the founding team right, then you can also get the remaining 2 points right. Now, the reason I've divided this video into three parts is because it is not just about hiring the right people, right? It is about hiring the people to do the right task. Now, in the initial stages of any startup, it is very important to know which departments to prioritize, which areas of the business should we prioritize in terms of hiring, and which areas do we need help, right? And therefore, in this video, we are going to talk about two things. First, the areas to be prioritized, and the second is how to hire the initial team. In today's competitive world, there are so many startups getting started. There are so many big funded startups out there. So why would a new talent, why would a great talent would like to work with you, right? You're not able to pay them well. You don't have that credibility. You don't run a big startup. So how do you attract talent? That is a great challenge. And therefore, many people get stuck here and they start doing everything by themselves. As a startup founder, it is not your job to do each and everything in your business, right? Your job is just to strategize and figure out the opportunities for your startup, and you need to delegate the rest of the work to your team. As a startup founder, you just need 4 things, right? First is having a great idea. The second is knowing what you know, and also knowing what you don't know, because only if you know that what you don't know, you can hire the right people. And the fourth important thing is that make sure that all of the people in your team are able to work well together. Now that is an important quality of a startup founder or any leader. He makes sure that his team is working in unity and is working effectively and with efficiency. Okay, so coming back to the two parts of this video, the first part is areas and departments that you should prioritize in terms of hiring the initial team. So all these positions or departments are not in any order of hierarchy, but these are generally the 5 most prioritized departments or areas that need hiring. The first can be tech and product managers, right? So if you are running a tech business, or even if you're not running a core tech business, but you need to have tech, right, to scale the business. So the first thing that you need to do is that you need to get in a great tech talent, right? The product manager who understands the product well, who is a great developer, who can design a great product for you. So the first is tech team, a tech member, and a product manager to develop a great product experience. Now, the second important area to hire for is sales. Now, even if you have the greatest product in the world, you have no business without sales. You always need salespeople. Now, every big startup, even if it is worth billions of dollars, needs thousands and thousands of salespeople. For example, Byju's. Byju's is currently the most valued Indian startup, right? But still, it hires thousands and thousands of salespeople each and every year, as they call it, business development associate. That is nothing but salespeople, right? So sales, you need to hire a great person who is great at sales, who is great at pitching, presentation of the product. Now, the third important area that you need to hire for is marketing and advertisement. Now, in today's world, marketing and advertising is very easy and is very cost effective and is very efficient, right? You need a person who is very good in SEO. You need a person who is very good in social media marketing and creating social media campaigns, right? Because social media is the first place where your customers can directly connect to you, and therefore you need a great marketer who has experience in SEO and also in various types of marketing like social media marketing. Now, the fourth important area and department that you need to hire for is legal and finance, right? Now, legal and finance is something that you don't need to necessarily hire in your team, but you definitely need to outsource it to a great person, right? Because legal and finance is very important part of business, right? You need a CA to manage your finances. You need a legal team to keep you out of copyrights or trademarks or any kind of legal issues that the startup may face, right? And therefore, legal and finance should be the fourth important department that you should prioritize while building your initial team. Now that we have understood that what we want to hire the people for, now we need to understand how to hire the right people. Now here, the first point I would like to tell you is don't outsource the hiring to hiring agencies, right? HR agencies are of no use for startups because they're just focused on hiring the candidates who meet the right skills. But we don't just need the person with right skills, but we need the person who has the right attitude, the right aptitude, the right passion for the growth of the business. And therefore, the initial first few hires should always be done by the founder and the co-founders, right? It is very important to pick and choose each and every employee, the initial employee that you get into your team. Now, when you are going to hire the people to join your initial team, the founding team, the core team, it is very important that you trust those people, you know these people, right? And therefore, it is a very common method to hire the initial team from amongst your friends or your colleagues or the students who were along with you in your college or in your university, right? And therefore, what you need to do is that you need to list down 10 to 15 people, smart people that you have come across in your life, whether they are from your job or college or university, and contact them, right? Make sure that they have the right skills for that to fit the right position, but make a list of those 10 to 15 people whom you know, whom you personally know, and contact them first. Now, the second way of hiring great people would be to get into the alumni groups of your college or your university, right? Now, just tap into that massive amount of network that your college or university has, and you can find great people in those alumni groups. You can also find some mentors who would give you priceless advice for free just because you are from the same college or the same university. So make use of your alumni network. Make use of your college network. Now, the third way to attract talent or to hire the initial team is to create a great profile on social media platforms. And by that, I don't mean Instagram or Facebook, but LinkedIn. LinkedIn is the great platform to professionally connect with other professionals, right? You can meet a lot of great people out there who have experience or who don't have experience, but who have skills and who have great attitude, right? Because LinkedIn is a great place where all the professionals are actually willing to connect with a lot of other people, right? And therefore, you can find the initial hires, the initial team on LinkedIn as well. You can also join communities on other apps like on Telegram, Slack, or Discord, right? So you need to make use of these social media platforms to the fullest to attract the great talent that is out there. Now that we have seen what departments to prioritize in terms of hiring and also how to hire the people for those departments, now let us see the third point, and that is the points to remember while hiring the people, the mistakes that you don't want to make. Now, the first is Don't delay in terms of hiring. If you need people to do some task, then go out and hire these people as quickly as possible. Hire them as interns or hire them as full-time employees, but get them into your team. Because if you have tasks and if you are yourself putting in your time in doing that tasks without delegating those tasks, then it is actually distracting you from identifying the other major opportunities and networking with great people out there. So hire as fast as possible if you need to hire people. Now, the second important point is hire for their potential and not their track record. Now, many people say that we don't hire the freshers, we don't hire these people. You know, if they have skills and if they have the necessary education, then I feel that you should hire them for their potential and not their track record in terms of job, right? Because freshers are those who are actually willing to take the risk and who actually have the passion to build a new product for the world. So therefore, hire for the potential. Now, the third is, during the interview, check the aptitude and attitude and the passion of the person for the startup and the product that you're building. It is very important. Skills are not important. Aptitude, attitude and passion is the first important thing that you should look into the person while hiring him for your initial team. Now, the fourth important thing that many startup founders miss on is design a standard operating procedure, design an SOP, right? So once you are through with 3 to 4 people, once you also have a person who manages the HR, the recruiting, then you need to draft an SOP, right? Once you draft the standard operating procedure for hiring new talent, that's the time when your work is done, right? Now, at that time, the person who manages the recruitment can use the SOP to hire the new people, and therefore hiring becomes very easy and very effective and very efficient. Now, the fifth is, don't treat your initial team, your initial founding members, as employees, because they are not your employees, right? The initial team is your family, right? These are the core founding members. Treat them with utmost respect, right? Because these are the people who will define the growth of your startup, who will boost, who will propel your startup, right? And therefore, you don't want to treat them just like an employee. Give them the freedom to speak, give them the freedom to put out their thoughts, to put out their suggestions as well, and make sure that they are treated very well so that they are retained in the organization and they don't leave the organization. And now the sixth and the last point that you need to remember is keep your team lean. A lean team is always very effective and efficient, right? As Jeff Bezos says that if you can't feed your team with 2 pizzas, then it is too large. So keep your team lean, hire only if necessary, and if you need, then don't delay in hiring the right people. So as that's it for today. I hope you have understood all these things, all these points. And if you want, then you can rewatch this video. You can go back and watch this video again. You can also suggest the topics on which you personally need help in the comment section down below. I'll try to make video on that as well. So guys, if you liked the video, then do like the video, share, comment, subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to hit the bell icon to receive the latest notifications of my videos on time. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, goodbye, take care, thank you.